Mission complete.
Ladies, gentlemen, and others, welcome to the final mission of the game. Quite easily, apparently.
I find you. When you say everything, there's an empty.
You are not one to be asking that question. It's dangerous to live, you could die. Suddenly.
What if I use the energy stored in Black Office to fuel my frail body? I feel like I have the strength of 10 men! Each of us has the strength of 10 men! The museum, based on the... So...
He's still weaker than Starbo. He doesn't beat a puff him up or anything. He's just like... acting really high and mighty. Ah! Yikes! Dude, psycho. Good screen caps, by the way. You couldn't be more of a loser.
Shut it, boy. Your name, Hipster Slang, is an affront to my ears and a waste of my time. Sleep, oh my ears, get
spilled. That's it. That's line. The perfection right there. Yeah, that's Lair style. Sorry, Jake, that was not a particularly good comeback. Our final mission for the campaign is another two-front map. Or a dual front. And they really, really, really want you to use Jake for the first front and Ranger for the second, because they placed both of their strikes really much. I don't care about that. That's yours, Jess. You do it. So, the main front, as you can see here, you have another 24 turns to win the map, because it's another time limit map. And your main objective is to destroy the Grand Bolt by hitting its weak points here, here, and here. But, problem, those weak points are shielded by a barrier created by the black crystals on the top front. And you have to win the top front. If you cannot win the top front, there's you just restart the map because you don't have enough time. At the end of every, at the start of every sixth turn of Von Volt's turns, another Uzi will spawn in front of each one of the weak points, ready to move their ambush spawns, and if you have a unit right in front of them, they'll be destroyed automatically. So, on the start of every sixth turn, move out of the way if you're starting to attack. With this front, there's, not much to really do here, just amass an army as quickly as you can, and then plug up these spots here while taking care of the Uzium as you go, while at the same time make sure to stop these infantry from capping all these cities so Bombwell doesn't get much income, and then get these and work your way back up. Also, for once only, this is the one map where you can actually make use of the pipe runners, and even then it's still not very good. As for the top front, as you can see, there's a lot of fundage going on here, which is why Rachel is good here, since she can help heal up all the damage you take from the top front. But there's also quite a bit of stuff to do. Fortunately, Kindle, who's coming to the top front, has no ways to get units. So what you see is what you get here. It's just a matter of how long can you win. And unfortunately, you cannot control the top front, much as I'd like to. Sasha hit rank 8 in the last map, so this is what we're gonna get for rank 8 skills. Brawler, inter attack plus 8%. Sniper, inter attack plus 8%. Slam Shield, direct fire plus defense plus 10%. Snipe Shield, Indirect Fire Defense, Assault Sound. That's it. Let's do it. Final mission, means to an end. Oh, Jess. So, to even drive the point home, they want you to use Jake Rachel for this. Jake has this big spiel about the whole power of friendship with Rachel, and he looks like he's about to say the big thing, but then gets friend-zoned by Rachel immediately, and he's like, yeah, okay, I guess. She ain't having none of that. I think the main call here is just build up a crew first. One transport. No one cares. Kindle is, you are literally a hanger-on at this point. Literally no one cares about you. Vomble's more interesting than you are. Gangsta General. It absolutely is. Say life, though. Huh. Odds are very good, she's just gonna get Urban Blight second turn. How much you really do about that? Helicopter. Now I have some extra funds. I should go by a little bit quicker. Keeps cranking out units, Jess will be fine. It is the law of the land. Maybe that's when I have to strike. That rocket, huh? That wasn't exactly back to back. Bothered with. Tanks. Ballsy. In a way, you'll have to go, if you go on the offensive, and they are by far, again, one of the best strats against the Uzium, so not too bad. Here. First song, so that's that's my train of thought. Light again. Yeah, that's pretty much a collapsed Lavos. It's, all of the energy of the Omega Land given form that he sucked. Can you stand against Ivan's ooze? Crap, that's a pretty good one. Thank you. I think Jess is in trouble. That first turn silver may have actually legit cost me. Four mega tanks or something. Were I to have the income, I totally would. Alas, I do not. I do not have the means to go that power. Tank, huh? You know what? Yeah, I'm gonna send up some of these. I think she needs the help. Do something with that infantry. He's about to get it. If I attack the Uzi, he's gonna get it, so bother. Use him to destroy the calf, at least. Oh, the missile? Seriously? I don't feel safe enough to meme yet. I think that did help a little bit. I got this Uzi at least. Yes, for that is what they're called. Museum. Save my money to not build anything expensive so he burns Ex Machina on, not something super powerful. Shut up, Ford! Gwyneth Paltrow, Scoop! Okay, that part's fine. Please do something with this, Jess. You're actually gonna get me worried about me actually losing this map. Now we're talking. Survive to use that silo next turn. Neighborhood units aren't that much worse. Ooh, nice. Let's get some refuel. One for one, I suppose. Which line was that, Starman? I have a feeling I know which one you mean. Oh, yeah, he does. Yeah. I giggled pretty hard. That is voiced. That entire scene is voiced, Rambo. They go in for scene in Alpha 3. Awesome. Oh. Should be able to do this. These three. 25, 50. Maybe not. 7. I can do it. Thank you. see here. Middle's done. Right is done. I'll use the null power here. Tank. Tank. he's got a Neo tank as well. Well, that makes my decision easy. Turns left. Let me be close. I can do it. I think I can do this. Join these. I'm just trying to avoid the targeting stone of a Ex Machina right now. Hitting. Well, that tracks, I guess. Neither of those are in any danger, so. Will be enough of the four of them. Yeah, that's quite nice of them. His naval units are too expensive. Even with all the extra hell, it will take too long. Part of that tank to go on the chin. Thank you. Thanks for that, Rambo. Right for the neck. Let's become headliners. But I've played 1, 3, and Wrath of the Cortex, though I've never really beaten any of them. I came close, to beating 3 once, though. 3's great, by the way. Do it again, I'd be glad to. That's fine. Kill. That's a one shot. nothing really else. Yeah, only fitting that we end up, that we end with a Mega Tank victory with the final blow. I was sweating a little bit with Jess, but she did it eventually. Dude, what now? This ability to self-recover. Damn, what did you do? Make the Devil Gundam? Devil Bolt? Aha! Oh? What's this now? So, destroy old man to save the world? Yes, no?
Can you murder a free old man?
Okay, Deckwood saw me. How many pieces of bread have you eaten in your life? Be reduced to rotten pumpkin! Old man, you know one thing about me? I don't miss! You don't get to die while I'm watching, punk. Welcome to natural selection, chum. So yeah, if you say no, Hawk does it instead. Oh, he sure did. You better give me a fucking S-Wing after that. Playing your needle game. You know, for the main front, I'm surprised that's all I lost. I mean, it's not a hard mission, but given the length of it was going, I was getting kind of scared. And that's that. We beat the video game. It's done. And now Rachel gives the party one last sound off. Yeah, she did alright, I guess. And my dear sensei. He still feels like he's 80 again. It's weird how, Pincer Attack was the harder mission. I hate that map so much. Hawk is not with us, but I will not forget the sacrifice that both of you made. And Ashley, fuck off. Disband? What? No! Stay together! Make the world a nice place! This is a good CG, though. I mean, Rachel, you're good at, like, one thing, your super CEO power. Nell is, like, good at everything. Except looking good in this game. She did it. Nah, but here's the real scene. To cost us. Oh. Nah, he's just giving him a nice eagle massage. Word. And then these losers. So anyway, day's ruined. Desert receding, green fields returning, Omega Land rebooting, Duggar experiences wistfulness, Duggar misses sand. Please go away. Please, I never want to see you again, Kindle. That's it! That was the campaign of a normal campaign of it's fun. It's goofy. It's a very goofy game. But I don't want to play it.
Like, Advance Wars 1 was pretty camp, but it had a little bit of the seriousness in it. Advance Wars 2, not, it was still camp, but also knew when to be serious a little bit. This game, maximum campy, but still a fun game. It doesn't miss for me. It's really telling just how different this game feels compared to the other two games, or the other three games, due to the whole dual story mechanic. This completely alters the pacing of the game, and shows. Handicapping myself felt good. I'm not like a super player or anything, but not busting the game's kneecaps wide open. It's fine, because when you play the game like it's meant to be played and not stacking things one on top of the next, well, I mean, some people find a humor in that, but I just for my good old try and true. Yikes. Yeah, that was a good playthrough. Good old Cal and I, we did it. We did good. I missed that playthrough. That was fun. No inhibitions of messing around, though. Still a little sad I got a B rank on Crystal Calamity. I did pretty good otherwise in that mission, but that power ranking is critical. Yeah, stuff it! Eat pant, nerds! Fuck it, just right. This mission is just nonsense. And this one's another one, it's just go fast or die. There's no in-between. I mean, there is an in-between, but I just don't care. Yeah, that was weird, wasn't it? Now for my favorite part of the game, the credits theme. I love this theme so fucking much. It's my favorite. It's legit my favorite theme in the game. It's such a fucking bop. So that's it. That's normal campaign Advance Wars Dual Strike. I really do enjoy this game. It even doesn't quite land the same way as all the other Advance Wars due to the fact that everything is just kind of like overpowered to the nth degree and back. It's the new CEOs. Some of them are fun. Others are just kind of like too into like, they, what they set to do, they, kind of oversell them with no drawbacks. Like, there's a lot of new CEOs in this game that don't, and, like, the amount of new CEOs in this game that don't have drawbacks, you can count on, like, one hand. And I feel like that's kind of a slightly missing point of Advance Wars. Like, you can have units or CEOs that don't do drawbacks or whatever, as long as there's CEO powers or super CEO powers benefit well enough. Like, look at Andy, I think, is a good example, and so as well as Adder. But feel like all the others, they just kind of, like, miss the mark a bit, a little bit, by not having something that's making them feeling weak, and the whole rank up thing was cool. I do enjoy it from as far as a casual player is concerned. When it comes to the whole make ready with trying to use things and have a level playing field, it kind of doesn't really work. Because the Warriors games really shine IMO, and when things are still level and you just can't like patch things up by having skills or whatever, just patching up whatever weaknesses a CO has. I'd rather just strategy win that game rather than just making things better like any other game. I feel like that stuff would work better if in a more refined setting, like Days of Ruin almost does it. Like, I feel like if Days of Ruin had that sort of thing with this, but like you leveled up and the perks of that CO, like what they do, just get better rather than just patching things up, I think that would be okay. But overall, I do really enjoy the game, even if the dual stream mechanic is kind of busted as hell. It's my first one. I adore the presentation, the music. I do like a lot of the new cast, like, as characters. I just think it's a nice, fun game to just chill with. Even sometimes when you just don't want a brain, this is a good advanced one to turn your brain off, and there's nothing wrong with that as well. It's just not my cup of tea. But I wanted to just go in. And Days of Ruin does that well. I really love this thing. Alright, excluding copyrighted games, stereo music program, reserve, Nintendo, and television systems. You'll love to see it. Hold on. Trying to get a screen cap of this without screen capping the whole stream later. Wait a sec. Come on. Yep. That's another one down. You love to see it. Right here. It is a little bit, given how easy the game can be. But hey, I did good with a handicapping myself, I think. Right. So that's a dual strike. I'm not done with this playthrough just yet. Still have a little bit to do. Hey Archie, how's it going? So once again, Hachi sells you the good stuff, and you can mess around. You can buy maps, CEOs, the works. You can also buy hard campaign. And what's that? Make Uzium? Sure, why not? Now you can be a nerd. This looks like it's my turn! Let's do it, Hachi. Oh,
by all the other COs. And here's where you get there, by their colors if you want. Here's the hard campaign. As mentioned before, the hard campaign is basically the story is turned off, but you just play harder versions of the campaign. But with cash is that you're allowed to use any CO that you have bought already, and you can dual strike as much as you'd like. Winning maps, you getting double points, I think. And honestly, most of the time, just play hard campaign as the game intends you to play hard campaign by using your favorite COs. It's easier than normal campaign. Overall. Right, so before we on the next session of Dual Strike that we'll do, we're gonna be doing showing off the combat minigame, which I love this minigame. It's a nice little bonus mode. It's really fun. You just kind of just bump through it. It's a great way to just burn time. And as well as promised Rambo I'd try this out. A round of survival. There are three rounds of survival in this. Depends on which one I'll try for. Time, turn, and fun survival. See which one I do. I might try and do fun survival. Well, I have to test something first. See if that actually would pop or if not, I'll try and do like turn survival. Yeah, that's a normal campaign of Dual Strike. Hope you guys enjoyed that.